Alright everybody, welcome to the Black Ice. Now I've gotten a lot of requests for this build lately. I usually don't give this build away. This is the build that I currently use. This is the build I use most of the times. When when I want to be sure it's the best build, this is the build that I use. This is like my Matt Zuccarello / St. Louis type of build. It's a sniper build. For some reason, this build is a glitch in different ways, and I'll show you as I go into it. Let me go into the attributes right now. So, right now, my guy, his height and weight is 5'8", 180. So, right wing is a 66 overall. You know why. Because I don't put anything offensive awareness or defensive awareness. I only do the categories that seem to be important to human players. All right, so let's get right into it. Deking 76. I'm not a loose puck deeks. I'm not that deking type of guy. Hand eye 84. Really anything above 85, 87, that range, it doesn't do much. Offensive awareness 65, don't really need it. You know how I feel if you watch my other videos. Passing 74, unless you're a playmaker, passing doesn't take effect unless you are actually a playmaker, where the higher passing helps you with the auto sauce and stuff like that. Puck control. Now I put puck control at 92 because, unlike my other builds where I don't have puck control, for this guy, since I switched my camera, I can, when I hold A to do the puck protect, the puck control seems to help me there. I don't know if it's because of the higher camera versus the lower camera that I'm using right now. I'm not sure if that affects it, but I just go at what works, and this works for this build. Slap shot accuracy 65, slap shot power 73, wrist shot accuracy 65. I will never, ever, ever change wrist shot accuracy. Doesn't work, doesn't affect anything. You still miss the net at the same amount. Sometimes you shoot right into the goalie, even if you have high ones. Wrist shot power, strength, that affects you big time in this game. All right, so the only categories on this page that count for anything for me is aggressiveness, body checking, shot blocking, and stick checking. So aggressiveness 84, body checking 78, still hits people even though he's little at 5'8". Defensive awareness, nothing there, doesn't affect anything. I think it's only for computer players. Discipline only affects if you check. If you use the right stick and try to check, discipline helps you with your elbows up, charging, stuff like that. Shot blocking 86, stick checking 75. Now I'm not explaining my boosts, like I didn't explain it here. You can just pause the video and go through it and look at it, and you'll see what boosts I use, and added to each. Now go to athleticism. Except this is the page that's the most important at any build you have. The most important part of any build. You cannot add anything to these other categories, and your guy, tell you the truth, doesn't change that much. There are certain aspects that change, but this is the one that really makes your guy worthwhile. So acceleration 90. Now 87 agility. Usually I don't put anything on my agility. Usually I put it at 65 because, like I said, I switched cameras. So I'm using a lower camera now, and the reason I'm using a lower camera is I want to score more. I'm tired of trying to set people up and they're not finishing. So with the lower camera, I can score more, be a little more selfish. I guess that's the wrong word to use when you're playing a team sport, but I want to be a little more selfish. So I use a lower camera. And I've always told you, if you use a lower camera, put on agility. So I've put on agility on my guy, 87. Balance 77 for this build. Or any other build that's small, your balance must be above a 77. Now this build is a glitch in the form of this. At 77, he stands up to hits like a power forward. It doesn't make sense, but even if he's 5'8", it's, I guess it's the right mixture for the sniper. At 77, he stands up to hits in the corner. He shrugs off hits. I don't know why, but that's just the way it is. Durability, 77. If you do get hit, you're going to get hurt. So durability, 77. Endurance, 80. Speed, 90. Strength, 83. I have 10 points left over. I could have mixed and matched and made sure everything maxed out, but it's really not that important. So let me go show you what the setup, just so you get the height and weight. Usually, I don't usually give this build out, but I've been asked for it a lot. So the game's been out long enough. It's not like you have to keep secrets. My pro, edit pro, right wing. Everyone always asks about the stick and the height and weight, which is a huge effect on the guy. So I just want to go in here and make sure I show. So the stick, this is 80 whip. I know this looks better because of the ratings, but it's not as effective as 80 whip with the mid open. Now the mid open for this guy works in the fact that he can go top shelf even if he's close to the goalie, and he doesn't miss the net that as much. That's the theme of my stick. He doesn't miss the net as much. That dictates what I select. Now, skates, 13-inch, always, it's pointless to use the other ones. All right, so height and weight. As you can go down, height, 5'8", 180. I find if you pick the height and weight of a certain player and you try to mimic that player's build, the guy that you create won't be as clunky as the others if you just randomized it. So 5'8 works. For me, my test is, when does he take his hand off? You saw he took his hand off the stick right there and hustled really quick. So when does he do that? Right away. That's usually my first test. And then I usually, as I'm setting up for a one-timer, he won't be twirling around. All right, guys. Thank you for visiting the Black Ice.